unique story. But before I do that, though, we've got some other special guests here today. So we've been in existence as a rowing program. Believe it or not, it's even hard to believe this, 18 years. I mean, I feel like I'm getting old because we were a club for the first 2 years. We were formed in 2000, and it was because I was breaking ground, or I was involved in the first dam for the Oklahoma River back then, and my wife, Tempe, and I started a club at Lake Overholtz, and a rowing program. I was practicing law at the time, but it had rained just enough the night before the event. I thought, we got to put some boats on the river and kind of plant that in the city's mind that this is something that's going to be really important to the future of Oklahoma City. Have an activated river, and have rowing, and have all these sports you never really probably thought to expect in Oklahoma City. And we did it, and it worked. I mean, people, that was on the front page of the paper the next day. But I also got a call the next day from Admiral Ray Ackerman, who was a trustee at OCU, and he said, you know, Mike, we have to start a rowing program, and will you do it if you get, and we can pay you $1 a year. I thought, well, that's a deal. And so I was an assistant private prosecutor at the time in town, so I did it, and I'd get up in the morning, I'd go coach, and I'd go into the courthouse afterwards, and I did that for about 3 years. And in that 3 year time period, I remember coming down here and running at lunch and just saying, I can't, when we get this ditch fixed, this could really be something special. And back then, selling the idea of a world-class venue with a ditch was a little tricky. People didn't quite totally get it at the time, but I think people were, I mean, they felt sorry for me, maybe, I don't know, because I was really passionate about it. But thankfully, enough people did listen. And one of those folks was Aubrey McClendon, who helped us with the first boathouse. Now, the first boathouse concept was not what you see over there today. It was a metal building, a really basic building that it was, you know, we felt like it was going to be pretty cool just to have something down here. But in the thought of raising millions of dollars at the time on a ditch was hard to comprehend. But we had, well, when we got our, see, our field is the river. When our field was built, we had our event. We invited Wichita State down. We thought that was a big time. Nothing against Wichita State, but I mean, that was the big time for us to bring them down and race. I invited the city, Aubrey, and everyone that came down, Ray, Admiral Ackerman. And we had, and this was a field, this was an old neighborhood, right, at the time. And we had the racing. People were amazed just to see boats in the water. And after that event, I will never forget, in the middle, it was literally, it was very common with Aubrey. We'd email like 1 or 2 in the morning. And that was really great, Mike. He was really excited about it. I said, well, you know, we have a chance to truly be world class here. No other city in America has a stretch of river like this in their downtown. And we can set the tone the right way, right from the beginning, and do something special. Or we could do this building, which would be great anyway. And Aubrey's like, absolutely, we gotta do this right, we gotta do a world class. And from that point on, he hired Rand Elliott, who designed and built the Chesapeake Boathouse. And the next, literally like the next week, I got another call. That this time was from Tom McDaniel at OCU. And I had been coaching this club, and I was at this time I was practicing law at the FAA. I was an attorney there. And Tom said, you know, we want to start a varsity rowing program. This is in 2003. For both men and women. Now, the rowers here know having a men's rowing program with scholarships was pretty unique to start that at the time. And I said, we want to do both. And he said, but the caveat is we'll do it if you do it. So I took a leap of faith, went from being an attorney to a rowing coach. And on our ditch, you know, which is and what was becoming a river. And from that point on, we really just dug in, and who would have thought within the first 5 years of the program, we'd have a world-class Devon Boathouse High Performance Center. It's been a remarkable rise as a program. Of course, I've become the executive director of the Boathouse Foundation. We've brought in other coaches to really be a part of this. Tom and Tanner and all the ones that came before you guys to help build tradition, build a history here. And before I finish this little history lesson, there's a lot of stories, and I won't bore you with them, but you really learn to understand and appreciate the dynamics of a river. And I bring this up especially for you guys here with the energy, because I just got to tell you, you guys have it so easy. I mean, you're on a field that, you know, if it rains, whatever, you know, you come back, you delay the game a little bit. Okay, our field moves, okay? So when the water, when it rains really hard, our field moves, we get this water that starts really flowing, and we have these lane lines you can see in the river. So bring this up, because I was literally thinking about this last night. It's 10 years ago, this weekend, we, because of the rise and the development of the river in 2008, we were awarded the Olympic trials for the Beijing Olympics, and that was a big, big milestone for the river to have the place that this is where athletes have trained their whole career to, for that one moment of making the team go to Beijing. I'm like, we don't want to screw this up. And so it had rained. We had one of those 100-year flood events. By the way, we had like 10 of those in the last 5 years. But we had a 100-year flood event, and it was, you know, this is what one of those days where I'm like, why would I ever stop being an attorney? I'm like, this is crazy, because it was like 2 in the morning, literally, and I was standing by that bridge, and the water was coming so fast, and I had all the rowing, I had rowing with some of the OCU rowers and that other coaches out, because we're like, we were all in it together. We were like, we have to make this work, because if it doesn't, this is going to be an embarrassment, because NBC was coming, and they're going to film this, and this is a big step for Oklahoma City. Well, one by one, the cable started snapping. I'm like, oh my God, this is awful. I mean, it was like, what, and the next day, literally, the athletes were going to start arriving, but the event was like 4 days from that day. And so the only thing that we had, there was no, this building wasn't built yet. We had this beautiful Dooley OCU pickup truck that was donated by David Huber. And I was like, we got this really nice truck, we're proud of. And it was the only thing we thought we could tie this race course onto to keep it from going, from leaving. And we thought it was a good idea, and we did, and it worked. We saved the course. It was like staying in place. So relaxed, went to sleep, got up the next morning, and the truck was gone. So I'm telling you, building this program has been about adversity, and you guys know what that's about too. You're building a new program from scratch, but I was trying to explain, how am I going to explain to Tom and Daniel, the truck, you know, at first I thought it was stolen, and then I'm like, no, I mean, obviously I woke up, and I'm like, no, it was pulled into the river through this flood. How am I going to explain this? Well, then I started looking at, not only that, we're at the crossroads of America. I mean, I-35 means I-40, thousands and thousands of cars each day. I don't want this to unfold in front of the world that we've got this truck in the river, and then the police and everything. But we got to get this truck out. And I got NBC coming and athletes and all that. So we started nervously like looking. We did actually literally saw bubbles coming up in the middle of the river, halfway down by 35. And so we called a wrecker. We got a diver. They went in, hooked it onto the truck, found it, and then pulled it out as quickly as we could before anyone saw it. And of course, the police did arrive, and I assured them there was nobody in the truck. Trust me. And as soon as they pulled it out, just enough, I was paying attention. I wanted to see that trailer hitch, because that's where we hooked the race board. And it came up, and there it was. The course was still there. So it was like a mild relief, but then I'm like, we got to figure out how to put this thing back in. So our grounds crew, which is like all the coaches, kind of went together, got in the boat, and spent the next like 48 hours nonstop putting the lane lines back in, making it look good, figured it out, and while the river was a little red, you know, because of all the churning in the water, the athletes arrived, the course was in, we had the Olympic trials, we qualified athletes for the Olympics, and I have on camera the athletes saying, gosh, that was like one of the best venues we've ever been to, and it was one of the best Olympic trials, it went over well, which then led to the next year becoming the U.S. Olympic Committee believing in us so much to be designating us as an official U.S. Olympic and Paralympic training site. So those things all kind of, it's amazing how these good fortunes or these challenges, they seem like huge adversities that lead to something even greater, which then helped us as an OCU program, helped us really formulate our vision for the program. And it's a unique vision for an intercollegiate program, in that we feel like we not only are developing young athletes and students to go on and do great things in life, but we're also helping athletes pursue maybe an Olympic dream if they have that, and to do it in a place where we have Olympic hopefuls. And so we created the first sculling program in America with scholarships, worked with the U.S. Olympic Committee on that, and have had great success with athletes, athletes in this room who have traveled around the world already to represent the U.S. And so it's not just, well, we're here to celebrate, we support and represent Oklahoma City University. In some respects, we also feel like we're advancing USA rowing. And so that's a unique role that we play in this program. So that's really the foundation of where we see this thing going in the future. We're really excited about the future. I think, feel like in the first literally 10 years of our program, we became a top 25 program in the country. Right? That's pretty, in a very traditional sport. It's pretty exciting. And so as we look to the future of athletes, we've had some challenges because we've graduated great athletes, and we have to, and now we're recruiting, and we're very excited to have three of our recruits here that are going to be here next year. You guys want to stand up? We have Brody Dennis, Cody Wilson, and Casey Brown. Welcome, guys. Part of our next generation here, we're going to carry the torch on, so we thank you for coming tonight. We expect big things, by the way, so it is, you know, we're really excited about where this program is going, where we're going with the city. Martha Berger couldn't be here tonight, but Martha, the new president, of course, Robert Henry, been president, been great, been very supportive. Martha was a founding member of the Oklahoma City Boathouse Foundation, has been involved in the development of the river since the very beginning. In fact, she's the one who introduced me to Aubrey Clinton. She is now the president, or will be the president, of Oklahoma City University, which is very exciting, I feel like, for not only the university, but for our program. So that's a little history lesson. Maybe you heard something, you can, you know, someday we'll write a book, I don't know, but there's a lot of those stories like that, but like I said, having a field, I mean, come on, it's not that, it can't be that hard. I mean, sure.
Where's the truck?
Yeah, well, okay, the truck is gone. So the truck was retired, unfortunately, but it was, I will say, that little investment in the truck was put to good use. I felt really bad at the time, but I think it really saved our hides, so yeah, it was a good deal. Okay, well, now I'm going to introduce back to the podium here, Tom, who's going to